Chillis. It was important for him to do it. He's done it.
Chillis is going to have to, at least for a moment here, call on all of his experience, and it's considerable. You know, keep Rawls away from him, and yeah. Rawls scoring again. He's got Chillis on the ropes, and that's not where James Quick should be. He comes fighting back.
And you know, now, because Chillis was the first man to take Tyson Chen, though it was done subsequently by Mitch Green, it is now almost a kind of a watermark. If you can knock James Quick Chillis out now, you've done something Mike Tyson didn't do, and I guess that's a sign of a certain mark of achievement.
And conversely, going 10 with Tyson seems to be a mark of achievement.
Oh, yeah, that's for sure.
Yep.
Well, Avery Rawls got his right hand in. Now here you see the experience of Chillis. He's been able to move a little bit, hold a little bit, and buy some time. And Avery Rawls not able to really capitalize as much as he would like on getting Chillis in trouble.
Now Richard Steele, who's nearly as big, he campaigned pretty good himself, but I think he was in the light heavyweight class, mm-hmm. if I'm not mistaken, if I remember correctly. He's in there with some big guys to move around.
Chillis is relying on his left hook a lot. That's why Rawls got that right hand in. Over the left hook of Chillis.
Let him go, James. Let him go. Don't hold it.
You can hear the instructions of Steele as we watch these two big guys bang away. Chillis very quick inside. Couple of nice punches. Tied Rawls up, moved away from him.
Wait. Jim Chillis is holding his left hand very low, and Rawls just looking for that lead right hand.
There's a right hand thrown by Rawls that connects. The Vegas folks here had made this one 6-5 pick 'em. One guy said, boy, Vegas gives everybody a chance to lose, huh? 6-5 I can't take credit for that line. One of the lads in the truck came up with it. He'll go unnamed. But it is an interesting thought. Right hand thrown by Chillis, and then he grabs and holds. Good right hand thrown by Rawls.
Chillis just stood there with his left hand low and took that right from Rawls.
And Rawls just stuck his left hand out, kind of just holding it there, and then just fired the right, didn't he? Now Chillis brings him back in the exchange, and I think maybe Chillis came away the best with that exchange, and Rawls seemed to lose. Chillis off his feet as he threw that. Handful of seconds, and round two will be in the book. Things are heating up here a bit at the boat. Round three coming up. We're back in the corner with James Quick Chillis. We'll eavesdrop a little bit.
Look at me. You're letting this guy do what he wants to do because you're not moving. You're standing right in front of him. You hear me? You're standing right in front of him.
I'll get him to watch.
You got to move. Pick off that lazy left jab. Pick it off, time it. Pick it off with your left hand. Hit him with the right. Come back with the hook. You're hitting him with the body with the hook, but you're not coming back to the head.
Double Avery Rawls' best moment right. In the second round. This freight train right. Look at the left hand of Chillis. It is way down in his waist, and Avery Rawls able to land it. At the end of the round, they both went toe-to-toe. The hand speed of Chillis becomes a factor. Left hand, you can see that left hook, though, slapping by Chillis. He's never been known as a great left hook artist.
Here we go, round number three. Chillis comes out a little quicker. Starting round number three. Rawls and he meet right in the center of the ring. Chillis, oh, good body shot. Left hand.
Chillis used to have a very quick lead right, like the one we saw him throw against Mike Weaver in those highlight films. It's not nearly as quick as it used to be.
Toe to toe, they stand.
And you can see from that exchange how much wider Tillis's punches are than in the old days, than when we saw on those tapes. It used to be just a pinpoint straight puncher.
He still has the quick about him, though, at least for a given period of time in any one brief session in the round for 8 or 10 or 15 seconds, which can be a lifetime. His hands are as quick as ever. Maybe not as long. Doing pretty good with that left hand in this round now.
Yeah, he is. I think Rawls is making him feel those body shots and the right hands he's landed. Avery is a good puncher. There's never been any question about that. And you have to be impressed with how committed Rawls is to the body attack.
Chillis pecking away. Blocks that left. Picks it off. That's the place to be, I shouldn't think, for Chillis. He's trying to just manhandle and shove Rawls around a little bit. Minute 30 remaining. think the comment by Tillis in his corner went unnoticed, that he said, hey, I'll get him, I'll get him. You know, as if to say, I don't, this guy doesn't belong in here. Well, Rawls, you know, is he makes no bones about it. This is the biggest fight of his career and the biggest chance for him. And he says he's worked hard for it. He's not going to come away a loser.
He's fighting in a very workmanlike fashion so far. It's obviously a very close fight at this point. But Rawls is trying very much to do the things he knows he can do against Tillis. Work the body and occasionally land that right hand.
I'm going to suggest to you that in this closing minutes, this round is going to be won by one of these two men that is pretty even right now. What do you think about it?
I would agree with that statement.
Somebody's going to steal this round in the last 20 or 30 seconds that we have remaining here in round number three. Who's going to impress the judges? And one form or another. A minute remaining. Round number three. Good right hand by Rawls. Nice uppercut by Tillis.
Come on, punch it, get out.
Tillis with a nice combination. 15 seconds remaining. Tillis again throwing a couple of good punches. Nice uppercut. Yeah. I think you know now who won round number three, don't you? That's it. We'll be back for round four.
Well, sure, how can I score? Avery Rawls, I mentioned the body attack, and he has really tried in earnest to go downstairs. And when Tillis languishes on the ropes, he can do it. You see him banging the body, feeling that he will slow Tillis down later. Tillis, though, showed his ability from the distance to throw some combinations, but it was the Rawls' right hand in that exchange that was really most effective.
All right, here we go. Round number four, scheduled for 10. James Quick, Tillis and White, Avery Rawls in the Cardinal trimmed trousers. They're gold. Cardinal and gold. Shades of Archie Moore. Archie used to show up in that formal length attire.
The old monkey.
Ooh. Solid right hand by Tillis, but Rawls didn't back up. Just keeps coming on. Bang into the body. Boy, you can hear that smack, and he nails Tillis with the right hand here in the fourth. And Tillis is giving ground.
Tillis came back with his own left hook, but this is the kind of fight Avery Rawls needed to make. I'll tell you what is really impressive about Rawls so far is his body work. Better, I think, than we've seen even in any of his other bouts. Tillis not fighting as one would expect him to fight. Again, not using his boxing skills as well as he'd like. Getting into exchanges with Rawls. Good straight right.
Yeah, Tillis. That's one of the few straight to the point punches Tillis has thrown. He's been kind of slapping with that left hand, at least in that previous exchange. Now they stand together and Richard Steele steps between them. Interested in the comments in Rawls' corner between rounds three and this one here, round four. They said, well, you won the round, but you lost the last 30 seconds. Interesting to see how the judges scored that. Because Tillis did have the flurry at the end of the round that appeared to have carried it.
I thought it was a close round to that point, as you had mentioned.
Yeah.
Don't hold it, Mavis.
Tillis came in at 212 and Avery Rawls at 201.
Come on, work inside again.
Tillis trying to flurry from the outside. He's not as accurate as he'd like with that right hand. Or the jab for that round. Rawls, to his credit, doing a little better defensive job, I think, than Tillis might have thought he would.
Rawls has some sock about him now, so does Tillis, but Rawls has knocked out eight of his 10 opponents. He's 10-1, and he's on a string of three straight coming into this one.
Tillis just knocked out Lorenzo Boyd about a month ago in the third round. He can still sting with the right hand.
Well, he's almost jumping off his feet throwing that left hook, isn't he?
Yeah, and that is something he started to do in recent years in not the greatest habit.
Yep, he's nailed Rawls with a couple of solid punches. Rawls keeps coming back, throwing that right hand of his own. And he may have hurt Tillis with that left.
They exchanged left hooks, and Rawls has shown he's got a good left hook. He is not just a right-handed clincher.
And I tell you, pretty good chin, too, out there, Al. They've taken some shots, each in turn. This is round four, scheduled for 10.
All right, don't lay in there, okay? Take a deep breath.
Take a deep breath.
Take a deep breath.
One more. Okay. When he steps back from the one of those exchanges, Avery, don't stand there and look at it.
Avery Ross.
Take the flag right away. Get back to the
opposition. With good right hands in that last round and the body work, that was, again, a trademark of him. Tillis from long range able to land some good shots, but by and large, Avery Rawls with a good body work in the left hook was able to get in there effectively.
We're in the corner with James Quick Tillis.
Work that jab, son.
Tillis being talked to. Now that's Eddie Futch over here on the other side. SportsCenter is going to follow our boxing tonight. Gail Gardner and Alan Massingale will be on hand. And the National League has announced its Cy Young Award winner for the year, and they'll have all the information to bring you up to date on it. SportsCenter to follow. Here we go. Round number five. Neither man has been down. Each in turn has jolted the other, and this is a very close fight indeed.
Mike Scott or Dwight Gooden? I guess we'll find out, huh?
We'll just take a guess.
I'll say Scott.
Oh, well, that's, we haven't got any. No bet.
Okay.
I think Scott wins it, yeah.
And the winner of this one very much up for grabs. I've got the fight dead even at this point.
In fact, I think I'm going to make a guess, a prediction, that Fernando came in second in the ballot.
Right. I shouldn't discount Fernando. Yeah. Look at Tillis turn to the southpaw stance. He's done this before. It's not the first time we've seen that from him in about. You know, an intriguing question as this fight goes on. Many believe that Tillis has the advantage because Rawls has only gone 8 once, and in his last couple fights he's gone 2 and 3, and in the one he went 8, he lost to Mike the Bonnie Hunter. But Tillis has a habit in some of his recent fights of fading a bit later rounds, even though he's been 10 and even 15 rounds. So who will fade if this fight goes on?
True, Rawls has never gone 10. And with the adrenaline flowing, enervating too, there's no mistake about it. This is a big fight for Rawls, and just the thought of it and the exertion of it out there, much to say nothing of the abilities of Tillis, it's enervating. And think of going 10. Interesting. Something to think about.
Come on, you got this work.
Richard Steele trying to pull him apart. He's a big man, 212 and 201. Tillis the bigger of the two. Minute 30 remaining here in round number five.
Work it out.
Neither man marked. Neither man has been hurt, I don't think, by the other. Any appreciable extent.
Lead right hand by Tillis getting in.
Yes.
And, boy, it could be such a good weapon for him, but...